Hello and welcome to Affinity. In another video I talked about the colour replacement brush, where you go to the paintbrush tool, right click, go to the colour replacement brush tool, pick a colour, and then when you paint it will replace the colour which is initially underneath it, so that when you get to the edges of things that new colour isn't there. However, as you see there, there's a bit of bleed going on, and this, you have to play with the tolerance to get that right. And more concerning is this is a destructive method. You're painting directly onto this background layer and you can't go back and change it. So the only thing to do is Control Z to undo it. Let's have a look at other methods you can use to have a similar effect. First of all, we can add a pixel layer above and just paint directly on that. So right click back on there again to get the paintbrush tool. And now we can paint directly onto the layer. However, with this, you notice this is coming through quite solid, and if you look over on the tree there, that's even more so. And so the colour replacement brush, you can see the texture, it only replaces colour but not the that texture. So we can emulate that quite easily. We go to where it says normal here, the blend modes, click on that, go down to where it says colour, and now the texture comes through. You can see it is on here, it's a bit harder to see. So that's how to fix that problem. Another problem though is that when you're painting again on here, it doesn't detect the edges. So let's just turn that off and we'll start again, but we'll start with selection. And you can select by various methods. You can do select by sample color here. Although there's also problems with that in how it selects, and that it selects all the areas and you know, bits you don't want. But if you've got a clear edge, an easier way is to use selection brush tool over here. So if you then got snap to edges set, when you paint it will snap to those edges and fill it in there. You can tidy it up, I'm not going to do that here, but you get that effect. Now if you put on a pixel layer with this and go to the paintbrush, then this will protect the edges. And again, if you go to the blend modes and down to color, you get the texture in there coming through as well. What else can we do? Something very similar. So I'm going to take that layer off. Oops, wrong one. There we go. I'll leave the selection on, but what you can do is use a fill layer instead. So if I go to layer and new fill layer, it fills in with the color that is selected at the moment, but you can change the color. So you can, fill layer lets you quickly switch between colors. And again, you can tidy up the edges of that if you want to. Take that off. One more thing that you can do as well is to use a mask instead of just a straight selection. So if I click on the mask layer here, then it appears to have selected just that, which it has, but it's on the background layer. So if I drag it down, it's now on a layer by itself, so you can't see it. I can hit Control D to get rid of that selection. Now I can put in a fill layer, or I could even do another layer, but let's do this. Layer, new fill layer, and I'll drag that to the top. Then I can use the mask. I can go up there to drag that to the mask there, so you get a vertical blue bar. And now it's got this area selected. I can also then paint on the mask in order to reveal more of that color. So if I paint in white, so if I select a paintbrush, select white, then if I paint on that, I can reveal the green in the fill layer again, and I could do more selections and so on. But you get the idea. So you can put extra layers in. Critically, if you want to make sure you see the texture, you go to the normal and go down to the color blend mode, which lets the texture through. You can use fill layers as well, and you can use masking. So there's a number of things you can do instead of using the colour replacement brush, and do it in a more non-destructive way. Thank you very much for watching.